Hi, welcome to Revenue Marketing Television, the CMO Insights channel. I'm your host, Jeff Pedowitz, President and CEO of the Pedowitz Group. Today as our guest, we have Nnamdi Nwoke, who is Head of Demand Generation at GreenSky. Nnamdi, welcome to the show.
Jeff, it's a pleasure to be with you. Thank you for having me.
I've been actually looking forward to this for a while. I saw you speak last month at Marketo Roadshow, and certainly I've known about you and your team. And you have a really great story with how you've moved through your career. And I was interested when I saw you on the panel, you talking about how you actually got into marketing. Well, let's start there. How did you find yourself on this path?
Yeah, I'm flattered, by the way. Thank you. Thank you so much. And it was a pleasure meeting you at the event as well. My story is, my path to marketing is an interesting one, I think. I grew up as an artist, right? I loved comic books, so I drew a ton as a young boy, but didn't really know what I wanted to do. My undergrad is in neurobiology and physiology, so I was preparing to go to med school, and after 3.5 years. Of that, I realized something's wrong. This isn't my path. And I didn't exactly know what I was getting into, but I knew how to get out of the pre-med path. It's funny, there was a huge event on campus, and I went to the University of Maryland College Park. Huge event on campus, and the guest speaker was Nelson Mandela. And I mean, you can imagine just the opportunity to see such a monumental figure,
that's a once in a lifetime experience. It's like getting an audience with the Pope, right?
Once in a lifetime. So of course, I mean, this isn't VIP treatment or anything. I'm in the nosebleeds with the rest of my roommates. The impact his speech had on me was resounding. I remember leaving that event and thinking to myself, I want to one day have an impact on people the way Nelson Mandela just had on me. And I didn't know what that meant, right? I had no clue what that meant. But I immediately picked up books on coding and development. I taught myself to code. I went into digital marketing. I began building programs, email programs, and B2B marketing automation program for some really great companies here in Atlanta after moving here. The rest of the story is, sort of unfolded where I fell in love with B2B marketing. I fell in love with the customer journey and ultimately ended up here at GreenSky.
That really is fascinating. So given your love of comic books, who's your favorite character, by the way?
Oh, Wolverine. Oh, Wolverine of all time.
Yeah, of course. So thinking about, I guess, the life of a superhero in the comics, how would you compare that with the role of the everyday marketer today and the battles that we have to fight?
I think what's lost in the stories I hear from some really incredible marketers that I've looked up to, I've mirrored my career after theirs for many years, is really the human element of what it means to be a marketing leader specifically. I was honored to be selected. It's part of the inaugural class for Marketo's Fearless 50. And really my story in leading up to being nominated and then ultimately selected was just sort of, it was empathy, right? And I think, I don't think when folks think of a superhero quality, they think of empathy, but I'm proud of what we've been able to build here in my current role, and the talent that's attracted to sort of the approach that we take to building great marketers, expanding their skill sets, leveraging technology, developing accountability, and really pushing each other past the boundaries so that we're achieving excellence, we're keeping ourselves accountable to making sure we're, doing what the business needs, but ultimately doing that with a sense of camaraderie, a sense of empathy for one another, and for me, really pulling you know, the leaders who I see greatness in, pulling them up to ultimately one day taking the seat of a senior leader and all the way up to a CMO. So for me, I love the opportunity, and that's what sort of is my oxygen. It brings me to work every day to know that I'm developing marketers who will one day sit at this seat and pass on some of the lessons of leadership, humanism, and empathy that that I've learned, you know, throughout my career, sitting under great marketers as well.
So I've got the comic book. It's Captain Empathy, right? So we'll
get that's good. You know?
Marketing,
that's
baby.
Good.
Marketing.
I love that.
So as you're, so obviously empathy, really important quality in a leader and certainly in marketing. But with all the technology, with all the challenges that marketing has too, what are some of the other important attributes you think or you look for anyway in your team?
Yeah, so it's interesting. Taking the role at GreenSky was, and working here at GreenSky has been one of the most transformative career decisions I've ever made in the best ways possible. So when I took the role, I inherited a team of about 6 marketers, and now we're growing. We are just about 14 marketers now in the team, and looking to add several more positions in Q1 2019. And I think the guiding principle for me in looking for marketers is, and there are a couple schools of thought on this. The school of thought that I love is one of Neil Patel's, and that's called the T-shaped marketer, where they have a breadth of knowledge across multiple disciplines in marketing, but really sort of are focused, right, depth, you know, in one or, you know, just a couple of areas. And that's been my approach to looking for the right marketers. It's, first of all, you know, your skills or your knowledge and experience, does it span the breadth of marketing that we look for? And I think the reason why that's important, especially for a company, a GreenSky, that's still sort of developing its business case for a modern, competent, and strong marketing organization, is we get to wear many hats, and we have to wear many hats working at a rocket ship, right, going at our pace. So first I look for marketers who have a breadth of knowledge and experience. But then in building out sort of the pillars of my marketing team, I look for folks who have depth in certain areas, and that's how I start to pair them with the groups that they work in today. And that's content, programs and campaigns, marketing operations, design, and now most recently, new to GreenSky at least, is building out a channel and field marketing organization. So so again, that T-shaped is a school of thought that I really sort of, you know, it resonated with me, and it served me well over the almost 2 years I've been here in GreenSky.
It makes a lot of sense. So there's been so much change in marketing over the last 10 or 15 years, and almost takes your breath away. But if you look out on the horizon, even 2 to 3 years out, what do you think the next big wave is going to be that's going to impact us?
Yeah. Demand generation has been my bread and butter for my career. I think what's happening for me and for most marketers, especially in B2B agencies or companies rather, is there's a shift back to some of the novelty marketing ideas, right? That sort of are the bedrock for modern marketing. And there's two that stick out to me as making their comeback, right? The first is brand. The first is brand, and I'll tell you why. I think some of the ideas or the techniques and technology that served as major differentiators, right, for certain marketing departments who were, you know, leading the change and blazing the trail, you know, using the most advanced techniques with email marketing. Companies like Silverpop come to mind with, you know, send time optimization, et cetera. Sort of that breakthrough, groundbreaking, you know, technology. Now all of those features you can really find across multiple different platforms, right? And some of the best practices that are proliferated by the great consulting groups. Most folks are catching on to how this stuff works in a modern 21st century organization. So I think shifting back, and this has certainly been my experience at GreenSky, is making a shift back to how we tell our story as marketers, to how we position the brand, to how we, and I'll go back to storytelling, tell that story uniquely, especially in a competitive space where most of our features and products and things are commonplace, right? So I think brand really, when I say brand, it goes beyond aesthetics. It's the story, it's the customer experience. It's how folks interface with your company well beyond their, when they make a decision to partner with you or to buy your products, et cetera. So I think brand is making a huge comeback, and marketers really have to double down on storytelling, but most importantly, customer experience.
Yeah, it's interesting as you say that, because I think we've gotten very caught up in the numbers and the science of marketing and the machine. And then along the way, that emotional connection, that human element that connects the company and the brand promise to your target audience. I mean, that's really the heart and soul of marketing. So I agree. I think we are seeing that kind of that whole round robin. And now, though, you have to be both, right? You can't just be a brand marketer or a demand marketer. You have to be a complete marketer.
Captain E. Absolutely.
So that E can stand for empathy, can stand for everything, right? Captain.
Captain everything. We're gonna do a comic book together.
We totally have to do that. I love that. Yeah.
Then let's do it.
Yeah. And then we're gonna have to come up with a vehicle and let's do the whole thing. And yeah.
I've already got it.
I bet you do. So your individual story is unique. And then it was quite a change, especially growing up as an artist and as a doctor. What are some of the lessons you've learned along the way, though? If you were going to kind of go back and tap yourself on the shoulder when you were a freshman in college, what would you go back and tell yourself?
I would tell myself that life is long, so be patient. Find the right mentors who are doing exactly what you want to do, and learn from them. There are incredible CMOs that I would kill for the opportunity to sit under their tutelage and learn, not just how they got to where they are, but the life lessons that have helped them to sort of stay in the game. So I would say to my younger self, listen, life is long. So be patient, take your time to learn, don't expect any handouts. And I say that because my story is interesting. The years that I spent sort of picking up books and teaching myself the skills I needed to land that first digital marketing role, those years aren't lost upon me, right? I still take that experience and those lessons, and I use them every day with my growing team here at GreenSky. And I tell them, in order to sit, when you finally get an opportunity to sit in the seat of leadership, your team is going to look to you for a number of things. But one thing that if I can pass on to my team, and a lesson that I've learned over the years, is they're looking to you to lead from experience, right? And I may not be the absolute best designer there is, but I've touched enough of the practice areas, right, in marketing that I can call myself a practitioner and speak and be respected, or my opinion be respected by everyone in my department, from the channel leaders to the campaigns folks, because I've gotten my hands dirty with the work. I think I would tell myself to, do as much as possible, get as much experience as possible, but really double down again and become that that everything marketer, right? That T-shaped marketer. That pretty much sums it up for me.
Well, Captain E, Nnamdi, thank you. It was an honor. It was an honor and a privilege to interview you today. We're gonna have to have you back for the sequel, especially when we launch the series, and we'll do a deal with the CW. Right? We'll get like a whole channel.
I'm on board, Jeff. Listen, it was a pleasure. Thank you so much for having me. It's really an honor to speak to you.
You bet. Thanks, Nnamdi.
Thank you.